I physically sat there and manually sent 100 messages. Finding a job can be really, really tough.
We don't have a job for you.
What do you mean?
I mean, we don't have a job for you. We've downsized.
You send off a bunch of resumes. Most people don't even have the decency to get back to you. And when they do, it's one of those awkward emails that goes out to like a million people telling you that you weren't good enough. And that's exactly what happened to me. So if I was on a dating app, it was like everyone swiped left.
Left swipe that.
You gotta swipe it left.
So a few years ago, I basically committed something I like to call career suicide. And I'm being serious. For some people, maybe committing career suicide's like being a dropout, like just not finishing school. Or for some people, it's messing up their grades and not getting what they needed. I became a monk for 3 years. Who the hell wants to hire a monk? Applying for a job as a monk, my experience would have been, I cared for people.
Okay.
I meditated for 4 to 8 hours a day.
Is this serious?
I woke up at 4 a.m.
I've heard enough.
No, but seriously, I also did a lot of good for the world. I worked on philanthropic projects. I even worked on sustainability initiatives. I helped build food distribution programs and educational programs. Some of these affecting hundreds of thousands and millions of people. But people really couldn't see beyond the monk thing. Then I read this study. It said that 92% of recruiters use social media for recruiting, with 87% of them using LinkedIn as the number one tool. I didn't even have a social media profile at this point.
How about getting with the program?
Then I thought to myself, there's over 39 million recent graduates on LinkedIn who probably have 3 years of experience. And then there's only 3 million active listings. 39 million, 3 million. 39 million, 3 million, monk. Now, the interesting thing about LinkedIn is everyone's profiles make them sound like an absolute god, right? It's like the best advertising agency, or maybe the worst, wrote every single person's profile. It's like everyone's managed multi-million pound deals and everyone's managed teams of 100 to 200. And then I found out that the most used word on LinkedIn to describe yourself, guess what it was? Write in the comments what you think what it was. It was the word motivated. Everyone is the most motivational and the most motivated compared to all the other people that they're up against. So I was thinking, how am I gonna break into this market? How am I gonna figure this out? I ended up rebooting my old LinkedIn profile from when I was at business school. I had about 100 connections. I started going through every single one to see who would remember me and who I remembered myself. And there were some funny ones in that. So I started to look through. There was that guy who really didn't like me, that girl who really hated me, that guy who kind of thought I didn't really turn up to class. Then there was the teacher's pet. And then I saw this guy that just looked like a nice guy, and I remembered him, and I was hoping he'd remember me. So I sent him a message. This was the hardest message I've ever written in my life. It was like harder than messaging a girl. I was nervous. I could feel the butterflies in my stomach. It was almost like I was gonna ask him out on a date. What should I say? Should I tell him where I remember him from? Should I tell him that his shirt and his picture looks nice? Is that a bit too much? Have I gone a bit too far? I haven't sent it yet. Okay, delete that. All these thoughts were going through my head, and I was trying to figure out how I was gonna send the perfect message so that this guy would respond. In the end, I sent something like this. Hey, we haven't spoken for many years. I'm looking to get back into the job market. Would love to be able to talk to you. And then I waited, and I waited, and I waited, and he replied. It was almost like someone just swiped right. I was the happiest I'd ever been, because he was the one person that responded out of God knows how many messages I sent. And that's how I ended up getting my first job after being a monk. So I'm gonna share with you my top tips about finding a job. If I can find a job after 3 years of living as a monk, I'm pretty sure you can find a job too. Tip number one, message everyone you know. There'll be someone in your network, family, friends, people that you studied with that will be able to help you. And the best thing is, don't ask them to just get you a job. Ask them about theirs. Learn about different careers. Learn about different paths and learn about their journeys. If you take an interest in that, not only will that other person be happy, but you'll gain so much more and know whether you're heading in the right direction. Lesson number two, don't get discouraged and disappointed if people don't get back to you. Most people barely have time to even reply to the people they love, let alone to the people that they may not even remember. It's all a game of odds and volume. The more messages you send, the more likely someone's gonna respond. Lesson number three, don't be scared to remind people regularly. I know people that I've had to message for weeks before they even responded. And the great thing about that is that you're really showing that person person, that you're persistent, that you care, and you're committed. Now, don't do it every day or every hour or every minute. Don't become a freak. Don't become one of those weird people. But make it regular. Once a week is absolutely fine. And the last lesson is see how you can help that person. Maybe there's something you can offer them in return. When you're asking someone for help, before you do that, the first thing you want to think about is, how can I serve that person? How can I help that person? And see what change you can make for them. Usually, they're so nice, you probably won't even need it. But it's a great tip to remember. Take along a gift, an exchange, or think about what value you can add to that person's life. And that's how I ended up changing my career suicide into the beginning of my career. And it all started through 100 messages on LinkedIn. I hope you liked this video today. Make sure you comment, make sure you like this, and make sure you spread it with all your friends who are looking for jobs. I can't stress to you how important LinkedIn is for making you get that next job. I am so grateful that you're watching my videos right now, and I hope that you're going to go on and watch so many more. But before you do that, make sure you subscribe to this channel so that you can find out about the videos as soon as they launch. Press the like button and leave a comment, and let's keep making wisdom go viral together.